Elsewhere on Capitol Hill today, lawmakers were seeking answers on the current living conditions of families in privatized military housing.
According to a new report, military families have experienced substandard, even dangerous conditions in their housing. Morgan Wright has more.
It's difficult enough to be a military family.
Our three children have only known their father preparing for or deploying to war.
But these military families came to Washington Wednesday to tell lawmakers about their horrible military housing.
Our ceiling caved in when we were home, exposing mold. It actually caused my husband to react to it. He now has permanent asthma from it.
Water was coming in everywhere.
One family had an infestation of 400 bats living in their attic.
Democratic Senator Jack Reed of Rhode Island says the private companies responsible for the military housing need to be held accountable.
Well, it's unacceptable for any family to be living in a situation where mold might compromise your health.
And Senator Tom Tillis of North Carolina says it hurts military readiness.
We've got the spouse at home talking about these problems and worried about the health and well-being of their children. They're not as ready.
The senators also grilled executives from companies that maintain and build housing for the military.
John Pisern is the CEO of Rhode Island-based Corvius Group.
We let down some of our residents. I am sorry, and we are going to fix it.
Pisern and the other executives blame poor communication, the condition of sometimes 100-year-old historical military barracks, and even extensive natural disasters for many of the problems. Senators suggested that Congress consider withholding payment to the contractors if they don't do a better job. In Washington, Morgan Wright,